Good morning and welcome to the December 8th County Commission meeting. I would remind you to silence your cell phones. The meeting documents are in the front row next to the Argus Leader personnel. The listening devices, if you're having trouble, Robert can help you with that, and he's standing in the closet over there. With that, we...
He's out of the closet.
He's out of the closet. With that...
Meeting adjourned.
Exactly. We will move on to routine business. Item number one is motion to approve the agenda.
So moved.
The motion, is there a second?
Second.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number two is approve the County Commission meetings from December 1st, 2015.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and second. Any corrections? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number three is bills to be paid in the amount of $208,853.14.
Pay the bills.
Is there a second?
Second.
I have a motion and a second. Any comments?
Madam Chair.
Commissioner Barth.
You know what, $205,000, that's about as low as our bill, or $208,000, that's about as low as our bills get on a monthly basis. And, you know, that includes an anomaly of a large number of bills from the coroner's department for transporting. Just a comment.
Okay. Thank you. I have a motion and a second on the bills. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number four is reports. There are none. Item number five is personnel actions. Item A is consider motion to approve routine personnel actions. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
The motion is second. Any questions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number six is applications for abatement. There are none. Item number seven is notices and requests. There are none. Item number eight is planning and zoning notices. There are none. Item number nine is petition for compromise of lien. Jeff Barth.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We have DP&O 73021. In the amount of $4,802.80. The applicant has requested a compromise of this lien upon a full payment of $1,000. The application reflects a request for a compromise in full with no payment, but now he's included a payment of $1,000. The lien includes human services, public advocate, public defender services between 2010 in March of 2015. One payment was received for $66. The same amount as the most recent charge incurred for public advocate. In the application, he says he was told that the public defender services would be $700, an amount he says he paid in 2013. There was a single charge for $700 in 2013, but there's no record of a $700 payment. He made the payments while he was on work release in Yankton. Payments may have been received down there and applied someplace else. The applicant's tax return reflects an income of $25,000, a refund of $7,000. He lists assets of $2,100, 2005 Ford Taurus, $100 in the checking account, and liabilities including $12,000 in Wells Fargo, Sanford, and Verizon. Says he's been clean and sober for 3 years and requests this assistance as he is a single father raising two sons, ages 20 and 18. I don't know if the applicant is here. No one has identified themselves as the applicant. If they were here, they could speak from where they are without identifying themselves.
I don't think the applicant is here.
So anyway, in as much as we're not going to dun this person at this time to chase him down and charge him excessive interest or anything, I'm going to make a motion, I don't know if I'll get support or not, to decline his offer, ask him to improve it, and see where we go from there.
Okay, I have a motion to decline. Is there a second?
I'll second.
A motion and a second. Are there any comments?
Madam Chair.
Commissioner Barth.
One other comment is there is no pressing need to approve this, as far as I can tell, based on a real estate closing or a personal property lawsuit or something. So we can wait.
That is true. There was nothing on this other than wanting to clean up his own record, and we take small payments. You can pay $10 a month. We're not in any big hurry. We just would like to be repaid for the services that we render. So with that, I have a motion and a second to deny. Any other comments?
Madam Chair, it looks like Mr. Wilson.
Robert, Mr. Wilson has a comment.
The only thing that I would just add to this as you're contemplating this is I did have a chance to follow up with the applicant, and I said we were a little confused on his claim in the application of making a $700 payment because, again, we had no record of that, and he didn't go into detail, but he said he did get that figured out. So I don't know if that was a payment that was made to another jurisdiction or what that was, but I just didn't want to leave that hanging that the, that was followed up on.
Okay. I have a motion and a second to deny. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Next, we'll move on to opportunity for public comment. This is the time when you can speak to the commission. We'd ask you to keep your comments to things that are not on the agenda and keep them brief. If you'd identify yourself, is there anyone that would like to speak to the commission? You have to come up and identify yourself and give your name and your address.
My name is Charles Tuttle. My
address.
Charles Tuttle, T-U-T-T-L-E.
Okay.
My address is 1919 Second Street Southeast, Minot, North Dakota. And the reason I'm here, I know that some of my fellow comrades that were petitioners came before you folks in reference to being able to petition inside public place. One of the things that my expertise is constitutional law, and I actually have case law that permits, not ask for permission, but permits and allows people to redress grievance within a public forum, public place. I waited till all the, I know we had a lot of stuff going on with all the other petitions and a lot of nonsense going on, so I kind of waited till all that died down and left before I came before you. I'd like to, I wasn't sure how many of you there was, so if you can copy these items. I've got the one case is Brown versus Louisiana, where four black men and a gentleman by the name of Brown walked into a public library. And this is one of the landmark cases that allows for people to actually go inside a building and redress grievance. So they actually ordered a book, did a sit-in, and were actually arrested and convicted of criminal trespassing. The Supreme Court overturned their convictions 5-4, saying that they weren't disturbing the peace, they weren't obviously stopping the business of the library, and they have the right inside a public place. In North Dakota, when I moved there years ago, we weren't allowed inside public places. People weren't aware of it. The Jamestown Mall case actually set precedence there, which a group went in and protested in the Jamestown Mall, a case where for against abortion. It was an abortion clinic there, and they went inside and protested. They were all arrested and convicted of trespassing, and that case was overturned based on the same premises. We now can petition inside the Fargo Dome, inside the Civic Center. Well, obviously, you have to be polite. You can't, you know, obviously there's other rules that if you're impeding the business flow, if you're causing a commotion, those are different issues. And those are grounds, obviously, to be removed. But other than that, there should be no reason why that we can't petition inside, you know, libraries now. I've been told, been telling people that, oh, you got to be 200 or 100 yards away. And what happens is a lot of times, and it's just people don't know, people in power, they feel that their customers, as they want to talk about it, are being harassed or whatever. And really, petition isn't about the petitioner. It's about the citizen being able to redress the government and having the opportunity to sign a petition. And the more places that they have that opportunity, the better off we are as a democracy or a republic. Because if they can't get access to petitions, if we make it restrictive, if you go out to California, go out to Washington, you can actually petition under the Pruneyard decision in front of a grocery store, in front of a You know, now obviously there's situations where people have been removed because they acted unlawfully, and that would be in any case. If you're not going to, you know, respect where you're at and what you're doing, then obviously you should be removed. But I think I know this gentleman here knows who I am, and I think he'll find that I'm very respectful, and most of the people that I work with understand that, you know, we want people to be able to walk by you and you know, want to walk by you, not avoid you. So I wanted to address that this morning and see where we can go to get some kind of compromise to be able to petition inside the courthouse here in a place that would be amicable to everyone. So I appreciate your time, folks.
Thanks. Thank you, Mr. Tuttle.
Thank you. Are there any other public comments? Okay. Seeing none, we will move on to regular business. Robert, our screen is down. Item number 10 is a public hearing to consider the application of special events off-sale package wine licenses, a special events on-sale wine retailer's license, and a consumed blend alcohol beverage license for the Wild Prairie Winery.
Hi.
You don't look like Bob Letts. We need to maybe start with Bob first,
okay,
and have a comment.
I just wanted to be here if you needed me to say anything.
Okay. And there are, as noted, three different licenses that she's looking for this particular event. Like you had just said, the consumed blend alcoholic beverages, the on-sale wine, and the off-sale packaged wine. And that's pretty much it in a nutshell. She's in good standing with the state's attorney and the sheriff's office, and she's here before us today to answer any questions.
Okay. Do you want to give, if there aren't any questions, I won't make you give your name and address. Are there any questions on this? Nope, you don't have to say anything. Thank you. Is there a motion?
Move for approval.
Oh, second. You know what? This is a public hearing. Is there anyone who wants to speak against this?
Yep.
There is no one who wants to speak against it. Now I would look for a motion.
Move for approval.
Second for a second.
Motion
time.
And a second to approve. All those in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number 11 is the review of the Prison Rape Elimination Act. Jamie Gravett. Good morning, Jamie.
Good morning. Jamie Gravett, Director of the Juvenile Detention Center. Earlier this year, I told you about how we were going to be audited to make sure we were in compliance with the Prison Rape Elimination Act. It was a desire of the governor of South Dakota to have all juvenile facilities PREA compliant by May of 2015. We had our audit where the person was on site April 1st through the 3rd. We had our initial approval early May with some fixes that we need to make. We worked with the auditor through the summer and received final compliance in October. I just wanted to inform you of that.
Okay. Any questions for Jamie? All right, thank you, Jamie. Item number 12 is consider a motion to authorize the chair to sign the 2016 fingerprint agreement between Minnehaha County and the City of Sioux Falls. Kristen Tarana, good morning.
Good morning. Kristen Tarana with the Minnehaha County Sheriff's Office, bringing to you an option to extend the fingerprinting agreement that we entered into 2 years ago. It's between the county and the City of Sioux Falls, and it allows us to provide fingerprinting services for the City Human Resources Department within the Sheriff's Office during our public fingerprinting times.
Any questions for Kristen? Is there a motion?
I have a question.
Commissioner Barr?
Budgetarily, this is as expected, or?
It is. It's exactly as expected. Our revenue totals for 2014 were $10,035 based solely on what we received from the City of Sioux Falls. And then in 2015, year to date, as of last week, was $9,900. So we're bringing in exactly really what we thought we were going to bring in, and it is able to directly reimburse the additional staffing that we added in order to accommodate what they would like to have 5 days of fingerprinting instead of prior to this contract, we only had 3 days. Additionally, that provides a better service to the public as well. We're able to offset those costs, but be able to provide more flexibility for those that would like to come in for public fingerprinting.
So it's not a money maker, but it covers its costs.
Exactly, exactly.
Any other questions? Is there a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve.
Second.
Motion and a second. All those
Madam Chair, I'll be recusing myself on this.
Okay. All those in favor, do we need a roll call vote, or we just do all those in favor say aye?
Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes 4-0.
Thank you.
Thank you. Item number 13 is consider motion to authorize the chairman to sign construction change order number 2 on the contract with Sukup Construction for project number MC1416 for an increase of $21,532.21.
Good morning, Commissioners. DJ Boothie, Highway Superintendent. This change order is a final change order for this contract, and it is a fairly significant increase as far as the change orders that we've seen for other projects this year. Most of it is due to increase in riprap. When we fill in scour holes and unknown spaces, it's subject to some uncertainty when we put the plans together. So we had a lot more riprap that we used in this case than we had originally planned. Fortunately, 81.95% of this will be reimbursed by the South Dakota ER program. So the cost increase for us is relatively small. And we do need to have this approved in order to process the final pay application. So if you have any questions, I can answer them now.
Any questions for DJ? Is there a motion?
I'll make that motion.
I have a motion.
Second.
And a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number 14 is consider a motion to authorize the chairman to sign construction change number 2 for a decrease of $123.38 to the contract with SFC Civil Contractors for Project MC Bridge Bearing 2015 repairs of bearings on three structures.
Commissioners, this was one of our bridge maintenance contracts that we had this year. Again, this contract is necessary to execute or to approve the final pay application for the contract. It's a small decrease of the final of the original contract amount, so not a big change here. Just need to do the formality of the change order before processing the pay application.
Madam Chair.
Commissioner Barrett.
It seems to me like, when we're on the Planning Commission, we put items onto the consent agenda, and then we don't have to, assuming there's no objection, they just get routinely approved. And, discussing a decrease of $123.38, it seems to me like we could have easily dispensed with that item and put it in there along with, say, approving the minutes and made our time a record for our meetings.
Our 15-minute meeting shorter.
It could be shorter. But I'll make a motion to approve this reduction.
Is there a second?
Second.
I have a motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Thank you, DJ.
Thank you, Commissioners.
Item number 15 is authorize Planning and Zoning Office to purchase one Chevrolet Silverado half-ton 4x4 extended cab short box in the amount of $24,574 from Billion Auto in Sioux Falls from contract number 16866, competitive bid by the state of South Dakota. Scott Anderson, good morning.
Good morning. This is an item that is in my 2016 budget. in working with the vendor, it's a two to three month delivery window. So we're putting this together now, anticipating it'll be delivered sometime in February or March.
Okay. Any questions for Scott? This is a budgeted item. Is there a motion?
Make a motion to approve.
Is there a second?
Second.
A motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. Item number 16 is consider a motion to reappoint Mike McDonald to a second 3-year term on the Siouxland Heritage Museum Board of Directors effective January 1st, 2016. Bill Hoskins, good morning.
Good morning. Bill Hoskins, Director of Siouxland Heritage Museums. Mike McDonald is one of the four appointed positions that the county gets on the museum's board. Board members can serve 2 consecutive 3-year terms. Mike has completed his first one as of December 31st. We are requesting that you reappoint Mike for a second term.
Are there any questions on this appointment?
Madam Chair, I support that and I'll make a motion to do that.
Okay, there's a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Motion and a second. All those in favor say aye.
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 Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously.
Madam Chair, we also have another party whose term is expiring, and we're looking to find candidates for that. Is that right, Bill?
That's correct. Marty DeWitt has finished his second 3-year term, and we're looking for other candidates to fill that position.
Okay. Thank you. Item number 17 is Minnehaha County Liaison Reports. Are there any reports?
Just briefly, last week I attended a CCOG board meeting, and through that process and the growth of CCOG grant-related issues, we revised the budget, if you will, for 2015, and we also engaged a wage study on the individuals who currently work there. So those two things are completed and in the process of looking at other additional studies in the future.
Any other liaison? Commissioner Kelly?
Tomorrow Jeff and I will be going up to the SDACC meeting. One of the items that's going to be discussed is in a December newsletter from the Municipal League, who we've been working fairly close with, is a thing, you know, trying to protect the city sales tax, and that no other governmental agency should get. Our chair, Dwayne Sutton, has really questioned what our situation is on this, because our Municipal League is on record as opposing letting any other governmental agency have a sales tax. And so I think it'll be an interesting discussion, and we're also going to have a joint meeting on with them on legislative issues, so I'm sure this will be brought up in it. And if there's anything else anybody wants us to bring up there, why let us know.
Okay, thank you.
Madam Chair, in response to Commissioner Kelly there, he and I will both be going up there. He has a small committee meeting also about the state convention next year, which will be in Sioux Falls. But I think there is a concern that, you know, that the municipalities seem to act with more gravity on their issues than we do. It seems like their issues come to the forefront somehow, and county issues are left on the wayside. And it's something we as commissioners, and that Commissioner Kelly and I will be all thinking about as we meet tomorrow and meet in the future.
Thank you, Commissioner.
And we will be hosting the convention in September. They're cutting it back a day, I believe. I don't know whether there's been action on it or not, but the intent was to cut it back one day and wrap up everything on Tuesday night. Is that right, Jeff? I can't remember. But however, instead of extending the elections and everything to the next morning, we've got a group locally working, right?
With yes. There's people looking at it. All right. Anything else for liaison reports? Is there any new business?
Madam Chair.
Commissioner Barth?
I would just ask our state's attorney to review the information Mr. Tuttle gave us and let us know what he thinks.
Is there any other new business? Mm-hmm. Any other new business? Is there any old business? Seeing none, I'd look for a motion to adjourn into
personnel and legal briefing, please.
For personnel and legal briefing executive session.
That's my motion.
Second.
And a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Those opposed, same sign. Motion passes unanimously. We are adjourned.